We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello friend, in previous lecture of vibration, we talked about 2 degree of freedom system, in which using 2 different frequencies of system, we derived 2 amplitude ratios of both the masses. Now using both that amplitude ratios and continuing our previous lecture, today we will discuss principal mode of vibration and mode shape. For any specific frequency of a system, there is a specific pattern of vibration that is called as mode shape. Means any particular frequency, system has a particular pattern of vibrations. For a different frequency of a system, it has a different pattern of vibrations, means different mode shapes. In previous lecture, we discussed two most important equations, equation number 7 and equation number 8. Equation number 7 is x1 upon x2. Is equal to plus 1, means when system vibrate with omega in one frequency, then amplitude ratio of both the present masses is equal to 1. Means when system vibrate with omega in one frequency, then amplitude of both the masses are same. x1 is equal to x2. This plus sign indicate that direction of the motion of both the masses are also same. If mass m1 moves in upward direction, then mass m2 also move in upward direction. If mass m1 is moving downward direction, then mass m2 also move in downward direction. From this equation, at a particular frequency omega n1, system has a particular pattern of vibration, means particular mode shape. If I will write 1 in the subscript of x1 by x2, then this one will indicate that we'll get first mode of the system, which is corresponding to first natural frequency omega n1. Now equation number 8 is x1 by x2 is equal to minus 1, means when system vibrate with omega n2 frequency, then ratio of amplitude of both the masses present in the system is equal to minus 1. Means amplitude of both the masses are same. This minus sign indicate that direction of motion of both the masses is in opposite. Means if mass m1 move in upward direction, then mass m2 will move in downward direction. If mass m1 will move in downward direction, then mass m2 will move in upward direction. This equation indicates at a particular frequency omega n2, system has a particular pattern of vibrations, means one more mode shape. If I will write 2 in the subscript of this equation, then these 2 will indicate that we will get second mode of this system, which is corresponding to second natural frequency omega n2. In last lecture, we have assumed a special case to understand the behavior of the system, in which we have assumed k1 is equal to k2 is equal to k3 is equal to k and m1 is equal to m2 is equal to m. So I am writing k1 is equal to k, m2 is equal to m, and m 2 is m, k2 is equal to k, and k3 is equal to k. In case 1, every point of the system is executing harmonic motion due to omega n1. In case 2, every point of the system is executing harmonic motion due to omega n2. The type of motion in which every point of the system are executing harmonic motion due to any of its natural frequency omega n1 or omega n2 are called as principal mode of vibration. Now, in case 1, both the masses amplitude are same and moving in the same direction. If mass m1 is moved with some distance in upward direction, then mass m2 will also move with the same distance in upward direction. Or if mass m1 move with some distance in downward direction, then mass m2 also move with the same distance in downward direction. Means spring k2 will act or move with this masses like a rigid body. Means there is no compression and tension in the spring too. There is no deflection in the spring too. And spring 2 will move like rigid body with both the masses. Spring 2 will not play any role in vibration of the system. If we remove spring 2 from the system, then both the masses will move like a single degree of freedom system, and frequency of both the masses is under root k by m. Now we'll make mode shape of the system. We know that amplitude of this mass is x1. Amplitude of this mass is x2. Now we also know that the amplitude of both the masses are equal. This is the first mode shape. Now, in case 2, we know that the amplitude of both the masses are same, but they will move in opposite direction. If mass m1 will move with some distance in upward direction, then mass m2 will move with same distance in downward direction. If mass m1 will move with some distance in downward direction, then mass m2 will move with same distance in upward direction. So in this case, spring 2 will experience compression and tension. So we need to study the behavior of the spring individually. Spring 2 will experience compression and tension, but one point which will not experience either compression or tension, that point is middle point of the spring. Now to study the behavior of spring 2. We have to consider the middle point of the spring. This middle point of the spring 2 will not experience either compression or tension. If this mass m is moved in upward direction, then the spring will experience tensions from this midpoint in upward direction. If this mass m is moved in downward direction, then the lower portion of the spring will experience tension in downward direction. If mass m1 will move in downward direction, then the spring will experience compression in downward direction. If this mass is moved in upward direction, then below portion of the spring will experience compression. So we can now divide this spring in two parts from this middle point. If stiffness of this spring is K and if we divide the spring into two, we know that when spring is cut into two, then its stiffness is double. So here spring two stiffness is K, and if we cut into two half, then this both half the stiffness is 2K. When this intermediate or second spring is cut into two, the stiffness is doubled. Now this entire 2 degree of freedom system is converted into single degree of freedom system from this midpoint. Now if we will write natural frequency of this single degree of freedom system, then it's K plus 2K by M, means it's equal to under root 3K by M. Means when this system is cut into two, then this mass and this both the springs are in parallel. So in parallel, stiffness of the springs is add up, means this K plus 2K is 3K. Now we'll make mode shape of this system. The amplitude of this mass is x1. The amplitude of this mass is x2, but is in opposite direction. Now we'll join this. This is second mode shape of the system. In the first mode of vibration, both the masses have the same amplitude and hence the middle spring is undeformed. Hence, we can ignore the presence of this spring and each spring is operating independently. Hence, the natural frequency of this system is omega n1 is equal to under root k by m. In the second mode of vibration, the two masses are exactly out of phase. It means two end of the intermediate spring move by the same amount in opposite direction. Thus, the midpoint of the spring will be at rest, and hence we can consider the intermediate spring to be cut into two and arrested at the middle point as shown in the figure. We know that when spring is cut into two, its stiffness is doubled, and when two springs are in parallel, their stiffness are add up. Thus, the equivalent system is converted into single degree of freedom system, and natural frequency of the system is given by omega n2 is equal to under root K plus 2K by M.